In 1981, a cast of veritable American rock talent coalesced under the nameplate Balance and released two albums chock full of melodic rock greatness. And from the first of those albums, the track Haunted.
Through a cloud of smoke, the room is filled, and I can't seem to let her know. She's so far away.
No, sorry, we had that riff, but we have the vocalist coming up with his own vocal melody that just really takes the song up to a new level. Like, within the space of like two lines, he's really stretching out here and giving the song character.
I dream until the morning sun. Her face appears and I can't think of anyone.
And I can't think of anyone. Yeah, that's really what's making the song take flight.
She's my lucky day and she.
That dropout with the ivory as he sings above it, you know, goes into that kind of angelic tone, and it the chordal shift too right here is really key.
And I keep wanting to call her name. Haunting, her love is haunting.
Angelic harmonies.
And I keep wanting to see her again.
She'll be far away. I love that refrain, that far away. It's emphasizing distance, you know, and want. And
sometimes you can't have everything, but happiness is only something she can bring. She's my lucky day, and she is haunting. Her face is haunting, and I keep wanting.
Haunting and wanting, great rhyme.
To call her name. Haunting, her love is haunting.
Open cadences right here with that kind of explosive, you know, strum that sends it off.
And I keep wanting to see her again.
I love how the second chorus had more accents, had more development on it. Like the first one was really stripped. It was just a complete like drop out of all the instruments except piano and voice. And like the second one had a bit more layers to it, indicating that there was going to be that the song was about to break out into new territories. We're going right now as we go like full speed ahead with all the urgency and all the wanting of this track.
She's with me everywhere I go. I close my eyes and I just want to love her so. She's so far away.
You know, that riff by itself that we were hearing at the beginning of the song would have seemed, at first, the song seemed like it was going to be kind of ordinary, but the moment the vocalist comes on, Peppy Castro, and starts giving those melodic contours over that riff, and just hitting and emphasizing, accenting all the right notes within each of the chords that are hit, and just finding just such a unique like wave of melody there. The song just totally takes on its character. It's in a class of songs where it's really the vocals that first elevate the song. before the music starts to catch up.
Someday I'm gonna make it clear. I'll get my way in love, we'll never disappear. She's my lucky day.
Of course, once you become familiar with all the nuances of the song, all the layers, the riff becomes a bit more effective. It ages well. Explosive tom rolls that like start each new count of that chorus. Yeah, that was Balance with the track Haunting off their 1981 eponymous release Balance, the first of two albums by this melodic rock supergroup fronted by Peppy Castro, a rock journeyman who had been doing lots of things over the prior 15 years. He started out as the rhythm guitarist in 60s garage rock band Blues Magoose. We ain't got nothing yet. A Nuggets comp classic with that fuzzy, like, Yardbirds guitar to it. And then in the early 70s, he was in a band called Barnaby Bye with the Alesi Brothers, kind of a Nilsson-esque, like Revolver-esque pop rock band. And then in 1970s, they did two albums, Barnaby Bye. And then in 1976, he surfaced once again in the funky hard rock funk rock band Wiggy Bits, who put out one album, one really good album, chock full of great funky hard rock. And then, of course, in 1981, he resurfaced yet again, this time in more slick melodic AOR rock band, Balance. And except by this point, he's not playing guitar anymore. I guess they figured someone else was better for that job in this group, Bob Kulick. And but Peppy Castro proves to be a very effective, moving vocalist, able to find the right vocal melodies, able to just bring the most out in the song, as he was within the first 10 seconds of this track. And let's see, some of the other talent on board here. Bob Kulick, who does the guitar, who was doing the riffs that we were hearing. He of the shaven head, he had been in, he was in the English rock band Hookfoot. Huh. I actually didn't know off the top of my head that there was a connection between Hookfoot and Balance. Yeah, I don't know if he was on, how long was he in the band? Hookfoot were like a rustic rock band out of England that had some connection to Elton John's backing band. Yeah, Caleb Quay. I'm looking at the credits of the first album. I don't see him on here, so I haven't quite learned anything I didn't know already. He's not involved in the album that has that great cover of Bluebird. Hookfoot, like rustic rock English band, kind of in the vein of Help Yourself, Shape of the Rain, the English branch of country, of early 70s country rock. Let's see, who else do we got here? John Siegler playing most of the bass. They don't seem to really have a steady bassist. They've got two bassists on the album, so maybe they didn't really quite nail down that role. Drums by Andy Newmark. Familiar name. Huh. Played with a lot of people. 397 credits on Discogs. And anyway, this album has a lot of great songs in it, like Looking for the Magic, American Dream, a real epic track I should do one of these days. And it's got the very melodic, very slickly chorded Breaking Away. And that song was new to me when I first heard this album 13 years ago, but it turns out Breaking Away almost made the Billboard Top 20. It peaked at like number 22, 23 in the charts, and so in some parts of the country it's a familiar radio evergreen. Because when a song stalls at like number 23, it usually means that it was popular in certain markets and got a lot of radio airplay, and still might be an evergreen in the, but not here in the Northwest. I found out that it was known to more people than just AOR, like album explorers, when I by chance saw it covered in a YouTube upload being performed on one of those 2000s era like singing competition shows by the very lovely daughter of politician and brief Massachusetts Senator Scott Brown, who unfortunately got unseated in 2014. But yeah, his daughter was doing a rendition of Breaking Away. Like maybe it was American Idol or one of those other shows. Quite a delightful surprise. Breaking Away, that track has congas by Jimmy Malin. Yeah, that he did a 1980s solo album. Yeah, Beats Working. It's a good album. Yeah, and he was on a lot of people's. He was also like a serial session musician. So anyway, and keyboards on this track by Doug Katsaros. 103 credits according to Discogs. Quite a few of these people were on albums by, had some Kiss connections. For more Rubies and Sapphires from the Two Balance albums, see the directory of albums by American Maximalist Rock Bands, linked in the description. Yeah, after posting the Journey video to Still They Ride, I changed my mind about benching that directory. I noticed that it was up to like 150, so I was able to add a few more, and I could still add a few more as I look around. But currently about 54 some odd titles at this point by American Maximalist Rock Bands, meaning like symphonic rock, AOR, melodic rock. Yeah, linked in the description below for Reds and Purples from the Two Balance albums. And like and subscribe and comment on the points you liked or points you think could be added to this video, to the observation about the song we just heard. And until next time, this is Aragon, the world's most ear travel trimaximalist, signing off.